North Korea's attempt to launch its first spy satellite in orbit ends in failure. This after the rocket's second stage malfunctioned, plunging its payload into the sea. It also prompted emergency alerts and brief evacuation warnings in parts of South Korea and Japan. The warnings were later withdrawn, with no danger or damage reported. According to local media, the launch failed because of the instability in the projectile's engine and fuel system. Pyongyang has said it would send a satellite into orbit by June 11 in a bid to boost monitoring of U.S. military activities. The government vows to conduct another launch soon. Another tense encounter between Chinese and American aircraft. The U.S. alleged a Chinese fighter pilot performed what it called an unnecessarily aggressive maneuver near a U.S. surveillance aircraft. Washington said the incident happened last week when the U.S. aircraft was conducting safe and routine operations over the South China Sea in international airspace in accordance with the law. It comes at a time of already heightened tensions between Washington and Beijing over issues including Taiwan and an alleged Chinese spy balloon that was shot down after traversing the U.S. earlier this year. Despite opposition from hardline Republicans, a bipartisan deal seeking to suspend the U.S. government's $31.4 trillion debt ceiling hurdles its first major test in Congress. The powerful House Rules Committee voted 7-6 to advance the debt ceiling bill to the House floor. The bill will be up for debates in a final House vote Wednesday. Under the deal, the U.S. debt limit will be suspended until January 1, 2025.
Why are we here at this hour? Because Republicans have brought us to the brink of a potential default, the first in our country's history. And as the chairman, the former chairman, our ranking member, so eloquently noted in the beginning, this is a manufactured crisis. No question about it. House Republicans are in control. You have the gavels. You are in the majority. And the fact that we are now a mere few days from a potential default, because the majority has decided to engage in this hostage-taking that my colleagues have described, I think, is a dangerous harbinger for how this body may function into the future.
U.S. House Speaker Kevin McCarthy calls on his fellow Republicans to support the deal.
Do you realize of all the Congresses in the past, you can add up all the money that they rescinded and add them together? This is higher than that. And the idea that we fought so hard to get those work requirements and welfare reform, or the idea that you can make the president, if he wants to add a new regulation, that now he has to offset that. We haven't had that before. So I'm not sure what everybody wanted. We couldn't get everything we wanted.
60 minutes piece.
The time frame to get the bill passed through both chambers of Congress and signed into law is extremely tight. Lawmakers are racing the clock to avert a catastrophic default ahead of June 5th, the day the Treasury Department has said it will not have enough money to cover its obligations. Here's a dessert like no other. Take a look at the world's most expensive ice cream. Japanese ice cream brand Gelato officially earned the Guinness World Record this week for its flagship treat named Byakuya. The price tag for a scoop, a whopping 873,000 Japanese yen. That's over 350,000 Philippine pesos. That price will get you an ice cream with an edible gold leaf, a rare white truffle, and natural cheeses. The ice cream has been described as rich in taste and texture. Gelato is planning to release more products with other expensive ingredients, such as champagne and caviar. Typhoon Betty weakened further early Wednesday, but State Weather Bureau Pag-asa warns it may still bring rains to northern Luzon. Betty continues to move over waters east of the province of Batanes, where storm signal number 2 remains. Meanwhile, wind signal number 1 is still up over parts of northern Luzon, including Cagayan and Isabela. Betty is packing winds of up to 120 kilometers per hour and gusts of up to 150 kilometers per hour. The storm is expected to leave the Philippine area of responsibility by as early as Friday evening. It will then head to Japan. The Kingdom of Saudi Arabia is offering 1 million jobs to skilled Filipino workers. The Philippine Migrant Workers Department said a special hiring program will be developed by Saudi Arabia and the Philippines to facilitate the hiring of 1 million Filipino workers in the next 18 to 24 months. Among those needed are for the hotel and restaurant, construction, and information technology sectors.
kailangan pagandaan natin. Oo. At kailangan din kausapin natin yung TESDA para balanse yung ating approach. Ang sabi kasi nila sa ngayon nasa 700,000 dahil sa pandemya. Ngayon gusto nila maibalik yon sa dating numero. Dati kasi number one tayo sa Saudi. Ngayon parang nasa number three. So ang gusto nila ibalik sa mahigit 1 million pa nga kumplete.
Aside from Saudi, the United Arab Emirates and Oman also expressed interest to offer more jobs for Filipinos. Senators grill the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation, or PAGCOR, due to its handling of offshore gaming operations in the country. This as human trafficking reports involving Pogo hubs rise. Ara Perez has the story.
There was a failure of intelligence in the Clark Development Corporation when it was not able to identify a Clark Pampanga-based accredited Pogo hub, which is a suspected online scam hub. This was admitted by the CDC during a Senate hearing into the rescue of over 1,000 people, mostly foreign nationals who are allegedly human trafficking victims. The victims were supposedly recruited to entice people to invest in cryptocurrency.
As a consequence of this operation, the board and the management created a special administrative committee just to investigate and hear all of the security officials of PSD, and they are now under preventive suspension. Good. Wala pong nakarating sa management or sa board na merong, let's say, red flag na po pala ang nangyayari dun sa hub na yun.
The CDC said it has a direct lease agreement with a company, which then subleased a portion of the property to a corporation.
San Valley Clark Hub Corporation applied with the PAGCOR as a Pogo Hub, and they were able to get a PAGCOR license for this. They constructed 8 buildings, and amongst the 8 buildings, yung dalawang building, they subleased it again to CGC Technologies Incorporated. You can see there at the bottom the Colorful and Leap Group Company. This is actually the respondent for the issued search warrants of Regional Trial Court Branch 81 of Bulacan. Sa records po ng CDC, hindi po lumilitaw ang Colorful and Leap Group Company. It shows that either hindi po in-endorse either Sun Valley or CGC Technologies sa CDC.
Dito po sa Building C and E, dyan po yung actual operations ng company. So nahuli po natin yung mga tao dyan. Naabutan po ng ating mga raiding teams, no, red-handed in flagrante delicto po, na andun sa mga computers lahat ng mga tao. There were others who were rescued in other buildings.
PAGCOR explained it was in 2019 when the said corporation in Clark was accredited as a Pogo hub, which is only one of two Pogo hubs accredited in the Philippines. Under the Offshore Regulatory Gaming Manual, a Pogo hub must be accredited, which is a complex with offices, dormitories, convenience stores, and others that workers may need. This should house offices of government agencies like DOLE, Bureaus of Immigration, and Internal Revenue. But PAGCOR admitted these were not found in the corporation that was raided in Clark. There should also be a twice-a-week inspection in Pogo hubs.
Twice a week nyo in-inspect, pero yes, may 1,100 human traffic victims doon?
Yes, sir.
Anong klaseng inspection ginawa niyo?
The latest inspection, sir, was April 28. So,
of?
April 28 of 2023.
Okay.
Before the raid, sir. Oh. And during the inspection, wala naman silang nakita, sir, na irregularities at that time.
So, paano nangyari yun? Yung police may nakita, yung CDC may nakita, yung PAGCOR na nagbigay ng lisensya, walang nakita. Hindi nyo ginagawa yung trabaho ninyo. Pinikit nyo yung mata ninyo. Ang tanong, bakit? This brings international shame to us. The Philippines is becoming a scam hub. Hindi Pogo hub, a scam hub. Pogo being used as front for scams. Pogo's being used as front for human trafficking. Because PAGCOR is corrupt and not doing its job. That's the bottom line. Pinagloloko nyo kami.
PAGCOR said the license of the said company in Clark has already been revoked and will not be allowed to operate again. The owners or representatives of the corporation were also invited to the next hearing. Senator Risa Ontiveros is convinced that POGOs are just legal fronts for online scam hubs. Ontiveros is hopeful that Malacañang will do something.
I hope Malacañang has been paying attention and taking note. Ang POGOs, nagbukod sa kakarampot ang ibinibigay na economic contribution sa ating ekonomiya, bukod sa napakaraming social costs na sinisingil sa ating lipunan, siya pa pala ay nagbibigay ng legal cover sa mga criminal activities na ito.
Senator Grace Poe proposes to investigate the background of heads of government agencies, especially those in law enforcement, amid cases of human trafficking, while Senator Rafi Tulfo wants to look into the process of getting a visa for foreign nationals. To date, the repatriation of foreign nationals victimized in the online scam hub in Clark has started. Cases in violation of laws against human trafficking, cybercrime, and illegal detention have also been filed against 10 foreign national suspects, while some have been convinced to stand as witnesses. The Interagency Council Against Trafficking is implementing stricter border controls in the country and investigating government officials who may have been complicit in departure procedures. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Over now to the closure of the General Hands Orphanage in Quezon City. The executive director of the facility denies receiving any warning letters from the Social Welfare Department asking them to make improvements in the orphanage. Charity Hefner Graff also refutes claims of overcrowding in their facility.
Gentle Hands has a reputation of compliance. We have always tried to comply with whatever concerns with every aspect of the program because we desire to be good at what we do for the sake of the kids. I can only state that the August 9 letter that has been referred to several times in the media is not a threatening or warning letter. It is actually a response to a letter that we wrote in May requesting consideration for certain items. This was not a warning.
The SWD Secretary Rex Gachalian earlier said, as early as August of last year, they warned General Hands about supposed violations which eventually led to its closure this month. The agency cited lack of social workers, as well as fire safety measures in its facility as reasons for shutting it down.